Hi, my friends. Today's video is all about a comparison of the Estee Lauder Hydra Rescue and the Estee Lauder Double Wear Light. I have been loving actually both of these foundations. I think they look really great on for different reasons, which we will discuss in the video, and I'm going to do a complete try on for you. I'm going to also show you after several hours what it looks like. Today the weather is in the upper 80s and it does feel a little bit humid, and yes, I have had several hot flashes already, so I'm sure that when I show you after several hours of wear, you're going to be able to see what these two look like through hot flashes, through the weather today, and actually just regular wear and tear of what I go through in my day for my makeup. I'm just wearing a regular t-shirt from Amazon, which I will try to link, but look at these earrings, everyone. This is from another creator here on YouTube, and she makes this jewelry. I will have all of her information down below. It's My Life Wendy, and she shows a bunch of her stuff on Instagram. She does a great job. I did a surprise package where I just sent her an amount, and she sent me whatever she felt like of these, and I told her that I love silver, I love hearts, I like purple, I like pink, and these came, and I am in love with every single one that she did. I'm probably going to do an Instagram story so that you guys can see them. She's such an artist. She's so great. So we better get into this review right now so that you guys can see which one would work better for you of the Hydra Rescue from Estee Lauder or the Double Wear Light for mature skin over 50 right now. All right, first thing is that I have primed my face with the e.l.f. Putty Primer. This is a primer that I use almost all the time. It fills in the pores. It helps even out my skin texture. So I love this. It's the one that I use all the time. We're going to put on this side of my skin. This one is the Futurist Hydro Boost, and it does have that SPF in it, and it's called Moisturizing Makeup, and my color is 2C3, and this is a perfect color for me. So we're going to start out with two pumps because unfortunately these don't come out very fast here, but we're going to start with two pumps, and I'm just going to dot this all across. That actually might be a little bit too much for me. We're going to start there, and I'm just going to dot it all across. And I will tell you guys that this is not the first time that I have worn this. I wear both of these all the time. I've been testing them extensively. Spraying my sponge just with some setting spray that doesn't have any alcohol in it. And I'm gonna pick up just a little bit off of there onto my sponge, and I'm gonna just work that around. Now, what this particular one does, it has a lot of moisturizing factors in it, but it still has the coverage. And I think that is so great about it. It just covers my mature skin so well. It just really is a beautiful, beautiful foundation. I've really enjoyed using it ever since. But if you do have oily skin, if you have really oily skin, you're not going to like this because it does have that moisturizing factor in it. And so just an FYI there, that is what I have found with it. It is highly, highly moisturizing. If you set it down afterwards with, I don't know, with the powder and with a setting spray that does have a little bit of alcohol in it, like All Nighter, then I think you're probably gonna be okay. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the rest of that second pump because this basically will not cover right here where I need the most coverage. And I'm just going to dot that around with the Beauty Blender and just work it in a little bit more so I have the coverage level where I want it to be, but at the same time, it's not getting cakey because I did it in two layers instead of just putting a ton on at once. And you guys can see that coverage is really pretty. It's not looking like it's giving me a cake face. It's not super thick there. It's just really thin, and you can see almost the dewiness on my face. If you're somebody that likes a glowy finish, a dewy finish, this is really good. Okay, we're gonna move on to the other one. And this is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Light. Same color, 2C3 Fresco. Just gonna clean off my hand here with a towel, and I'm gonna squeeze out about the same amount. Now, this one is a little bit thicker. The last one was a little bit more watery. It ran a little bit faster across my hand. That is a factor that you might need to look at. And again, I'm gonna take the other side of the sponge. I'm gonna spray it with that setting spray. This will be linked below. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna dot this all across the face. Now, like I said, this one is a little bit thicker. It goes on a little bit thicker. It is nowhere near as thick as the regular Estee Lauder Double Wear, but that's why I like it. Can you see what I got on my nose, you guys? Ollie, he, was playing with me, and he did a little nip, and he just tracked across my nose. So yeah, got a little scab going on there, for thanks to the puppy. But that's okay, because that's part of being a doggy mom, and I love it. First, you're gonna see my blemish right there. I have two of them right here right now, and those are not going to cover with the first pass, just like this one didn't. We can see that, and it really is not going to be a full coverage. I would say it's gonna be a medium coverage right off the bat. But if you want to build it up, you absolutely can. So I'm going to do exactly the same thing. I'm just going to take a tiny bit more, and I'm going to put that on the sponge, and then I'm going to dot that across this area here that I need. All right, so I think that you can see. If you can't, I'm going to walk you through this, what I'm seeing. This side right here is already drying down a little bit. This side still feels dewy. It still feels like I've got something on there that needs to dry down. That's the moisturizing factor of this side. Now, for my super dry skin in the winter, that is going to be fantastic. I have my hot flashes, and I am a little bit warmer right now because we're still into a little bit of the summertime. And so I find that this one in particular does better. The Estee Lauder Double Wear is what I used to wear all the time. The reason that I love this one a little bit more is because it doesn't give that thickness that the Double Wear Regular did. Double Wear Light gives a thinner consistency. It goes on a little bit thinner, and yet it still gives a really good coverage. This is definitely a medium coverage. For me, this one was, you know, like a medium to high coverage on here. So this light, it's really giving you just a little bit of see-through on your own skin. So if you don't have a lot of blemishes, this one might be just perfect with for you. If you have normal skin, you don't care about that SPF, you don't care about the hydrating, then this one might be perfect for you. I am taking just a little bit of concealer, and I'm just going to go over those parts that are so red and then that blemish and try and hide those. So for me, even looking at it right here as it is, it's beautiful. It's really pretty. I love both sides a lot. I feel like the side that is the moisture one, can see that it's covering a little bit better. I do feel that dewiness. I will, you know, throughout the day, I will feel that dewiness unless I set this down. I'm going to use the Milani Prep Set and Glow to set this down. This does have a little tiny bit of a subtle glow itself. I do like that, but I'm going to probably have to set this side down completely. But I find that I really do, with my menopause and all of my power surges, my hot flashes, that I have to do that anyway. All right, through the magic of video, I am going to get the rest of my face done. Ta-da! So this is the finished look, everyone. I absolutely love both of these foundations. I think that they have a place in my makeup for anybody. I do really, really love the way they both finished for different reasons. The Double Wear Light acts very much like the regular Double Wear, only it's a thinner formula. It doesn't look as foundation-like, so you're going to get a little bit more natural of a look to it, and it doesn't quite cover as much as that one. Obviously, from what we did today, it did have a little bit of a problem covering the really tough parts. But what I do love about it is that it just looks so pretty on the skin. It just looks so much like skin. I just think that's so beautiful. And then on the Futurist Hydra Rescue, this is definitely a foundation that is going to be very moisturizing throughout the day. If you're a dry girl, or if you tend towards getting dry throughout the day, you're going to find that that is something that you're going to love about this, that it is going to perform so well throughout the day. Never ever get to the end of the day and look at either one of these foundations and think, ooh, I don't like that. I'm going to show you pictures of what they both look like just for a second, so you can kind of see both of them and kind of get a view of them. But like I said, I think that both of them have characteristics to them that lend themselves to different skin types. This one, the light, it's going to be great for you if you have that oily skin. If you have that skin that's normal combo, it's going to be really great for that. But keep in mind that you're not going to get as much coverage as you do on the moisturizing, which is strange because the moisturizing foundations usually don't cover as well for me, but this one does. It just covers so pretty. And the other thing is, I feel like I used less of the Hydra Rescue than I did of the light Double Wear. And surprisingly, I do feel like the Hydra Rescue is a thinner consistency than the light double wear. So those are my comparisons on those, and you got to see what they look like at the end of the day. They really compared the same as far as wear time goes. So don't go off of that. Go off of what you think would work better for your skin. If you like a dewy finish, go with the Hydra Rescue. If you like a more natural finish, go with the light double wear. So I hope that you did enjoy this video. Please give it a thumbs up on your way out of here. Thank you so much for spending a few minutes today with me. And I will catch you guys all in my very next video. Love you. Bye-bye.